गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टडीड 1-1 एंड ऑन टू फंक्शन एंड आई ऑल्सो टोल्ड यू सम क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग दैट. सो इन एक्सरसाइज 1.2 इन एक्सरसाइज 1.2 we face question third. Function from real number to set of real number it is given, and it is given by f of x is greatest integer function x. Question says show that function is neither 1-1 nor on 2. This is a question. Now let me explain first that what is this sign. This is called a greatest integer function. This concept was belonging in class 11th. If you have forgotten, let me explain. This is greatest integer function x, and what is its meaning? Let me say something. Suppose this is a number line, whatever the number x here, when greatest integer function applies on that, it gives its less and nearest integer. Very important sentence. Less and nearest integer. Like if I am writing here 1.1, so where is 1.1 here? So answer will be less and nearest integer, meaning 1. If it's supposed to be 1.2, 1.2 is here and its answer is again less and nearest integer, 1. So finally I would say till 1.9. sometimes students get confused. 1.9, the student used to reply answer 2, but it is not so. Less and nearest integer is again 1, and integer function of 1 is only 1. So it means that all this numbers with the greatest integer function gives 1. Okay, let me say something. So what about here? We have to go that solution. I start here. Function is integer function x, and we have to show function is neither 1-1 nor on 2. First I will go with 1-1. As I taught you the concept of 1-1, you used to take f of x1 equal to f of x2 and you prove x1 equal to x2. This is a concept of 1-1. But not always, student, you should use 1-1 meaning, 1-1 meaning if these are two sets. Suppose A, B, C here, suppose D, E, F here. So images of element of domain should be unique in the codomain. This is 1-1. Okay, but if condition comes for you, these are two sets. Suppose it is A, it is B, it is C, it is D and it is E. Suppose this condition comes. The images of A and B are single number. It is a many one. It is not 1-1. So this is also a very important concept of showing 1-1 or many one. If function is many one, it is definitely not a 1-1. So we use same concept here. Student, if you focus that given function is f of x equal to x, and this is a set of real number to real number, meaning we can choose any real number here instead of x. I am choosing 1.1, and not so long past time here we told you this. F of 1.1 meaning greatest integer 1.1, and you should know it is 1. Right now I told in that section. F of 1.2 is what? Greatest integer function 1.2, again 1. Very important. Again 1. So what do you think? That it is 1.1, 1.2. It is set of real number, it is set of real number, then the answer is having 1.1. The image of 1.1 is 1, the image of 1.2 is 1, meaning it is many 1. So in that case only one should prove that if the images are same, that's why function is not 1,1, or we can say function is many 1. We need not write that sentence. It is enough to say, it is enough to write f of x is not 1,1. So this was the simple condition. Now we'll go with onto. How to show onto? So what is the meaning of onto? You remember yesterday I discussed with you that what is onto. The onto meaning when the range of function is equal to codomain. So let me speak that for function codomain is set of real number. Now you have to find the range of f. So how to find range of f? Look at student. Function is this one. So I would simply tell you that without proving anything, it is actually the concept of class 11th. Greatest integer function, and whatever the number here we put, when this operation operates on x, always gives integer. I put some examples. 1.1, what we got? 1. 1.2, what we got? 1. And all the numbers, like suppose 2.1 gives you 2, meaning here always comes integer. So you should know that this is the greatest integer function, and you must know, we know that the range of this time function is the set of integer, and therefore this time the set of integer is not equal to codomain, which is not equal to codomain, and that's why function is not onto, and that's enough to write. So hope student you got this function is very familiar function. So I have put this question just for practice. Hope you got. Now let me rub this and I'll move on the next question. Okay, so I take now question number five. 4 is very similar to the third one, so I think it's for your practice. So question number 5 is again an easy question. The question is signum function. That is not a new word. Signum function you already studied in class 11th. So let me write f of x. What is signum function? 1, when x is greater than 0, when x is equal to 0, when x is equal to x less than 0, f of x is equal to minus 1. This is a function, and which what to show? You can see in a book that we have to show that function is neither 1,1 nor onto. Okay, very easy again. So for showing 1,1, its basic concept is only that f of x1 equal to f of x2, and we used to show x1 equal to x2, but we won't use this method always. Sometime we have to change our method by seeing the question. And question seems very easy. How to show 1,1 or many 1? You should know that. I tell you one thing. For all x greater than 0, we have an image 1. Like, if I take x equal to 1, I ask you that for x equal to 1, what is the value of function? F of 1. You should know that this is 1 greater than 0. X, for all x greater than 0, the value of function is 1, meaning function 1. If we'll go with x equal to 2, student, f of 2, x greater than all number, answer is 1, meaning again answer is 1. So what comes, student? Since f of 1 equal to f of 2, it means function is not 1,1. Why? Because that time function is that time function is onto f of 1 equal to 1, f of this time function is many one. Function, the image of 1 is 1, the image of 2 is 1, meaning function is many one, it is not 1 1. Now it's very simple, I have told. Now I'll go with onto, and that's again the funny things. Onto is very easy concept. Look, students, see the function. One should simply catch first signum function is onto is decided. For all x greater than 0, value of function is 1. For all x less than 0, the value of function is minus 1. And at x equal to 0, the value of function is 0, meaning these three are possible values of function. Since range of signum function is, you can see with the question also, function is set minus 1, 0 and 1. Student, don't forget that you have to make a set. Set meaning there are only three elements, which is a range of the function. And you should know that time, which is not equal to, which is, let me write one main thing I forgot to write here. Function is given from R to R. One should know that this is a codomain and range is only three elements, which is not equal to codomain, and that's why function is not onto. I don't think that this is a tough one you have got till now. So let me wrap this question and I'll move on the further questions. Okay, let me tell you question number 9th. First I am telling you 9th and then few questions I have to tell you. Question 9 says your function is from natural number to natural number and is given by f of n is equal to n plus 1 by 2 when n is odd, when n by 2 when n is even. So what to show? For all n belongs to n. Question says state whether function is bijective. Show that f is bijective. Okay. First, I want to tell you the meaning of bijective. Let me complete the sentence that 1 1 having synonym, injective. Onto having synonym, surjective. Student, you can also write 1 1 onto and 1 1 onto together comes. 1 1 onto, it's called a bijective. These are important word term logic. Instead of 1 1, injective word used. Instead of onto, we can use surjective. Instead of 1 1 onto, we can use bijective. What to show? F is bijective. Meaning we have to show function is 1 1 and onto both. Okay, let me wrap this. This is a simple thing. Now, let me explain that how to show function is bijective. Solution. Bijective meaning we have to go with 1 1 as well as onto, both we have to show. First I'll go with 1 1. So see the function carefully. It's f of n having two different functions actually. F of n has been defined here by the two functions n plus 1 by 2 and n by 2, and they are different one for n is odd and n is even. So students will arise here three cases, and here we'll use similar concept I taught you, that f of x1 equal to f of x2 implies x1 equal to x2. This condition shows that function is 1 1, and we are going to use same concept here. So we'll take two numbers. Let n1 and n2 are natural number, n1 and n2 are natural number such that both are odd. Very important. Both are odd, because for odd and for even they are different. So we have to take one by one. Both are odd such that f of n1 equal to f of n2. Don't forget that for showing 1 1 we used to take f of x1 equal to f of x2. This time I am taking f of n1 equal to f of n2. F of n1 for odd condition, this is odd. F of n1 meaning n1 plus 1 upon 2. For f of n2 meaning n2 plus 1 by 2, and it's very easy task for you student. 2 and 2 will cancel, 1 and 1 itself cancel, n1 equal to n2, what comes? F of n1 equal to f of n2 gives n1 equal to n2, meaning this time function is 1 1. Function is 1 1, very important. For being an odd, function is 1 1. Similarly, you can go ahead that now let n1 and n2 two natural numbers such that n1 and n2 both are even for this only. Now I'll show that function when n is even, function is 1 1. F of n1 equal to f of n2, and you have to show n1 equal to n2 is again a easy task, student. F of n1 meaning n1 upon 2, and f of n2 meaning n2 upon 2 for being here. F of n1, n1 upon 2, f of n2, n2 upon 2. 2 and 2 will cancel, and the answer is n1 equal to n2, and again function is 1 1. Function is 1 1. So, student, in these two cases, f is 1 1, here also f is 1 1. Now, if third case, n1 and n2 are natural number taken, when n1 is odd and n2 is even, so one is odd and other is even, then what will happen? And let n1 f of n equal to f of n2, it's an initial condition for 1 1, and what to show? N1 equal to n2. So f of n1 equal to what comes for n is n1 is odd. So for odd, f of n1 meaning n1 plus 1 upon 2, and f of n2 meaning n2 upon 2, and one should know that 2 and 2 cancel, n1 plus 1 upon n2, which is not satisfying the condition like n1 equal to n2, meaning this time function is not 1 1. Finally, I would say only one thing: when n1 and n2 both are odd, function is 1 1, when both are even, function is 1 1, but if one is odd and one is even, function is not 1 1. So these are sufficient conditions we have to tell for showing 1 1. So I won't use other space, I would tell you here only for showing onto. Okay, onto, what is the meaning of onto? We have to find, this is a codomain, and we have to show that the range of function should equal to codomain, function will be onto. So how to find range? So let me explain something, that how to find range. I ask you one thing, when n is odd, when n is odd, what is the range set? What is the range set? Don't get confused about the word. Range set meaning 1 by 1 put n odd, whatever the answer of this coming, this is a range set. Let me repeat the sentence. 1 by 1 put n is odd, whatever the answer of f of n, this is the range set. Okay, so put n equal to 1 here, 1 plus 1, 2 by 2, 1. When n equal to 3 here, 3 plus 1 by 2, 4 by 2, 2. When n equal to 5 comes here, it's a 3. So I won't waste time. When n is even, then tell me the range set is what? When n is even, like 2, because it's a natural number, 2 by 2, 2 by 2 meaning 1. When you put 4, meaning 4 by 2 is 2, 6 by 2 is 3, and so on. So student, if you check these two, combine them, you will get a range set is 1, 2, 3 and so on, which is none else, it is equal to, which is equal to natural number, meaning codomain. So don't get surprised. 1, 2, 3, this is range set. 1, 2, 3, these are range set for these two different conditions. And finally, I would say that which is equal to the codomain, because the range set coming 1, 2, 3, it is a set of natural number and which is equal to this n. So if it is equal to codomain, function is onto, and ultimately I would say that function is 1, 1 and onto. So this is a question which was about to discuss. Now let me explain. Let me rub this. I think you got. So let me now complete question number 10. Is also looking very important. 10 is very important. Question number 10 says, very important question. Let A is a set r minus 3 and b is a set r minus 1 and L function is from a to b and defined as f of x is equal to x minus 2 upon x minus 3. Is function 1 1 on to justify? Question says is function 1 1 or on to justify the answer? Okay, we'll do it. So first of all, I would say something that your function is this one. So how to show 1 1? Very important and very simple. That x1 and x2 are the two function in the two element of A, such that what we used to take f of x1 equal to f of x2. So what is f of x1? And what to show, you know, x1 equal to x2? We'll get easily. F of x1 meaning x1 minus 2 upon x1 minus 3 is equal to what is f of x2? X2 minus 2 upon x2 minus 3. Now do the cross multiplication. This multiply this comes x1, x2, 3x1, 2x2, 3 2's are 6, x1, x2, 2x1, 3x2, 3 2's are 6, 6 and 6 cancel, x1, x2 cancel, 3x1 this will be minus x1 and minus 2x2 and this will be minus x2, definitely both cancel, comes x1 equal to x2 and that meaning function is 1, 1. Very simple. Now we'll show that function is onto. For showing onto, what to show? The range set should equal to codomain, meaning this should be range set. Okay, student. Now second, let me explain something that how to find range. Range. So what is the meaning of range? The meaning of range is after putting the values of x, the set. This is actually y. The set of values of y is a range set. In some other sentence, I would say something especially for you. Let it is y. Y equal to f of x. It is not surprise. So how I find that set of x which satisfy this one is domain and set of y for which it is defined, this is a range. So I would find the set of y. And how I can find the set of y which shows the range of function? I'll multiply, cross multiply here. Xy minus 3y is equal to x minus 2. And I will find x. How I? Xy minus x is equal to 3y minus 2. Take out x common. 3 minus 2 and x equal to 3y minus 2 upon y minus 1. I ask you simply that when x exists, this is exist when y should not equal to 1. And when we are finding the set of y, it is a range set. So I would say it is defined, or instead of that only you can write directly that. What is a range? Range is all the set of real number except 1, because if y equal to 1, this will not define, meaning x will not define. And x must define when r minus 1 comes. And this is because of y. And it is the set for y for which it is defined, that's why it is called a range set. And range is coming equal to what? B. B is a codomain, which is this one, which is equal to codomain. When range equal to codomain, function is onto. So that time function is 1 1 and onto. So this is a day. I think it's good enough for the day. So now do exercise 1.2 for yourself. Questions, if you would have any doubt, you can consult with me on my WhatsApp number. Thank you very much.